Today's topic is General Heat Conduction Equation. Myself, Mr. P.S. Chaugule from Department of Mechanical Engineering, SITCOE, Yadra. In this lecture, we will derive equation for the Cartesian coordinates only. So for that, let us consider one element having the dimensions dx, dy and dz. Let me explain how the dx, dy, dz are. Here are the axes x, y and z. You can take z here and y here also. And this is the rectangular, small rectangular element. Now, the dimensions are dx in the direction of x. There is a dimension dx. Similarly, in the direction of y, sorry, z, there is a dimension dz. And in the direction of y, there is a dimension of dy. In such a way, these dimensions are. Now, if qx is the heat in flux, means heat inside of this rectangular block, we called it as influx, and whatever heat out from this element, we called it as heat efflux, right? So qx is the heat influx in the direction of x. So this is the area. Now next is the qx plus dx is heat efflux from this area, from this one area, right? So from this area, heat will out, qx plus dx. Similarly, you can define qy for this area, heat influx, heat in to the rectangular element, and qy plus dy for heat efflux. Similarly, for the z direction, qz is the heat influx in the element through this section, and qz plus dz through this section, right? Now let's say density of this element is rho, specific heat is C, and kx, ky, kz are the thermal conductivities along the direction of x, y and z. So for this element, we have considered as in a x direction, there is a specific thermal conductivity kx. In y direction, it is somewhat different, and in z direction, it is somewhat different. We called it as directional characteristics of material. Now, if the directional characteristics of material is the same in all directions, means if I say here k is the same in all direction, then that material we called it as isotropic material. And if it is not, then we called it as anisotropic material. So currently we have considered here anisotropic material, right? Now, let's say E dot is the internal heat generation inside the element per unit volume, per unit time. Is it? Now, the unit for this is watt per meter cube. Since I have mentioned over here, E dot is the heat generation inside the element per unit volume, per unit time. E dot, capital E, is the total heat generation within the element. Now, if we study this component or element during a small interval of time, what we get? Here is the heat influx, qx, and qx plus dx is the heat efflux, means heat input and heat output. Now, whatever the remaining heat inside of this element in x direction, we called it as net heat accumulated. Now, if we calculate net heat accumulated in the element due to conduction of heat from all the coordinate directions, means x, y and z, so whatever remaining, means qx minus qx plus dx, whatever the remaining is there, we need to consider it as net heat accumulated. and along with that there is a internal heat generation also. So if I add these two terms, whatever remain inside the element plus heat generation within the element, it will be automatically reflect as a energy stored in the element after time interval dou tau. This is nothing but the energy balance equation. We have balanced the equation, the net heat accumulated plus heat generation inside the element is equal to energy stored in the element. Now, so in this, the net heat accumulated in the element, we will find out that. So this is the formula for that. In x direction, qx minus x plus dx is the net heat accumulated in x direction. Qy minus qy plus dy is the net heat accumulated in y direction. Similarly, for z direction, if we add this, we will get net heat accumulated in all coordinates. So let's find out this one, qx minus qx plus dx. So as we know, according to Fourier's law, we can say that q is equal to minus k into area into dt upon dx. So if I write the formula for qx, it should be minus kx. As you know, kx is the thermal conductivity in x direction. Now the area, why I have taken dz into dy? See here, I need to consider this area because this area is perpendicular to qx. So I have taken here area dz into dy. The temperature dou t upon dou x, and in the time interval dou tau. And as you know, qx plus dx, you can find out qx plus dx by this method. It's a Taylor series expansion, and through this expansion I will get qx plus dou upon dou x into bracket qx into dx, right? So if I want to know this qx minus qx plus dx, this term, so for this I have to take this qx minus into this bracket. So this qx will get cancelled and the remaining term is minus dou upon dou x into bracket qx into dx. We know the value or expansion or the equation for qx, so let's put it inside the bracket. That minus sign, here it is one minus sign, and inside of that bracket is the minus sign, it will get into plus. So my remaining terms are dou upon dou x into bracket kx dou t upon dou x, and whatever the remaining terms are dx, dy, dz and dou t. Similarly, you can find for the y and z direction. So let's find out the total terms. So if I find the qy minus qy plus dy in the similar method, I will get this expansion or this expression. For the qz in the z direction, I will get this. And now if I want to find out the addition of all these terms, it will be in this way. Simply I have taken dx, dy, dz and dou t common over here, and all other terms are inside the bracket. So this will be the net heat accumulated in element due to conduction of heat from all the directions. Now let's find out the heat generation within the element. As you know, E dot is the heat generation inside the element per unit volume, per unit time. So if I want to know the total heat generation within the element, it will be E dot into volume. And you know that the volume is nothing but length, height into breadth, right? So dx, dy, dz. And within the time dou t, so I have taken here dou t also. And this will be the nothing but heat generation within the element. So the net heat accumulated, we are having this formula for heat generation within the element, we are having this formula. And now it's time to find out energy stored in the element. So as you know, mc dt is the formula we used frequently for the energy stored in the element. And now here m is the mass, c is the specific heat, and dt is the change in temperature. Now right now we are talking about the mass, but we don't know the mass of this element. We only know the density of the element. Do you know any expression or any relation between the mass and density? Yes, it is. The mass is equal to density into volume. So I can rewrite here. Instead of mass, I can take density, which is rho, into the volume of the element dx, dy, and dz. By this way, this formula mc dt will be converted into this one, rho dx dy dz into c dt. Dt is the temperature change. So I can rewrite this equation in this form. So multiply this by dou t upon dou t, so that I will get this expression. Rho c dx dy dz, dx dy dz is the volume, rho is the density, c is the specific heat, and I have taken here dou t upon dou tau into dou tau. Simply I have multiplied this equation by dou tau divided by dou tau. So this will be the equation or expression for the energy stored in the element. Now we are having all these expressions, simply add it. This is the net heat accumulated in all directions plus internal heat generation, total internal heat generation, and this one is the energy stored in the element. So if you look into this example or expression, you will find this is the term which is common at each expression. So let's cancel it out. So my new expression will be dou upon dou x into bracket kx d dou t upon dou x plus dou upon dou y into ky into dou t upon dou y plus dou upon dou z into bracket kz dou t upon dou z plus e dot is equal to rho c dou t upon dou tau. Remember that here dou tau is the time interval. This is the expression for general heat conduction equation for non-homogeneous. Remember here, non-homogeneous. Why I have taken here non-homogeneous? Because I have taken the various thermal conductivities in each direction, kx, ky, kz. That's why I called it as non-homogeneous material. Self heat generation, E dot, I have taken. And unsteady, because dt upon dou t is not equal to zero. That's why unsteady three-dimensional heat flow. So remember this. Or by using vector operator, you can write it in this way. Vector operator into bracket k into vector operator t plus E dot is equal to rho c dt upon dou t. Now as we know, we are having this expression, and now say if thermal conductivity is the same throughout the element, means in all direction thermal conductivity is k, then my expression will be, I have taken out k outside of this bracket, because now if k is not the function of x, y, and z, we can drag out to the outside. So inside a bracket, that is, these are the terms which remains, into k plus E dot is equal to rho c into dt upon dou t, dou tau. Or we can write it in this way. Simply I have taken k, or the whole expression, divided by k, right? So E dot upon k, this E dot is replaced by E dot upon k, is equal to rho c upon k. Now if I consider alpha is equal to k upon rho c, then the expression will be this expression only changed, right, at this point, 1 upon alpha. Now this is the general heat conduction equation for constant thermal conductivity. Now what does it mean by alpha? Alpha is nothing but thermal diffusivity, and we have defined alpha is equal to k upon rho c. K is the thermal conductivity here, rho is the density, and c is the specific heat. So we can define the thermal diffusivity in this way: thermal conductivity divided by thermal capacity. This rho into c is nothing but the thermal capacity. Now larger value of thermal diffusivity, when we get larger values of thermal diffusivity, either we need to increase the numerator or decrease the denominator. Means either you have to increase the thermal conductivity or decrease the thermal capacity. And that's why the faster will the heat diffuse through the metal, and its temperature changes with time. As we have seen, metal and gases have relatively high value of alpha. Why? Because the thermal conductivity is much more larger in metals and gases. But in non-metals and liquids, we have low value of alpha because of less value of the thermal conductivity. Now, other simplified forms of heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. Here are the some examples. This is the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates for constant thermal conductivity. So if I say no internal heat generation, that ultimately means E dot upon K, this E dot upon K is equal to zero. So my formula will be this one, and we called it as this simply Laplacian operator. We can use Laplacian operator square T, T is the temperature, is equal to 1 upon alpha, alpha is the thermal diffusivity, into dou T upon dou tau. We called it as Fourier's equation. So remember this one. This is the Fourier equation, and in Fourier equation, there is a no internal heat generation. Next one is the steady state condition. As you know, steady state means temperature does not depend upon the time. That ultimately means here dT upon dou tau is equal to zero. And since it is equal to zero, this whole term will get converted into zero. So this is my expression. I can use Laplacian operator in this way. This is called the Poisson's equation. So previously it was Fourier's equation, in that there is a no internal heat generation. And now if I consider only steady state condition, we called it as Poisson's equation. Next one, combination of these two, means steady state condition as well as there is a no internal heat generation. In that case, temperature doesn't depend upon the time. Also, if I say no internal heat generation, that ultimately means E dot is equal to zero. So the last two terms will get zero. So my expression will be this one. And if I want to use Laplacian operator, then Laplacian operator square T is equal to zero. This is the equation which we call Laplace equation. So see, in Fourier's equation, there is no internal heat generation. In Poisson's equation, only the steady state condition. And if we combine these two, steady state and no internal heat generation, then we called it as Laplace equation. Now next one, steady state but one dimensional heat flow. One dimensional means only in the x direction if heat flow is there. These two terms will get is equal to zero. And as well as if I say steady state, that ultimately means dou T upon dou tau is equal to zero. So we need to eliminate this whole term and these two terms. So I will get this equation. At the same time, if I consider steady state one dimensional heat flow without heat generation. Means in this heat generation also not there. So my equation will be dou square t upon dou x square is equal to zero. So for unsteady state one dimensional without heat generation, I have to write this one. Why? Because unsteady state one dimensional, that means dou t upon dou tau is not equal to zero. Without heat generation means E dot is equal to zero. So I need to eliminate this term only. So for this case, the equation will be this one. Hope you understand this. Please write it down in the notebook so that you can understand it in a better way or derive it in a better way. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.